I'm gonna try every Tuesday morning to do something, to show up about 7, so, yay! Since I forced you to start standing for the last early morning one, let's start laying down. I feel like it should be okay. You might have to look at the screen a little bit more, but we'll try. So start on your back, and you know what? If you want to start, grab a pillow and put it underneath you, or if you have blocks or a towel or a blanket, I think I'm actually going to start. I'm going to start with blocks. So they can go underneath shoulder blades, head, underneath your legs, whatever feels comfortable for you. And then your legs can be soles of the feet down, they can be more extended out, even soles of the feet together like Baddha Konasana. And then once you settle in, take a deep breath in and a big breath out. Big breath in. And I always feel like it's easier when you're on your back or your belly to move the breath around your body. So as you inhale, feel the chest, ribs, everything expand upward, outward. See if you can make that happen in your body. And as you exhale, feeling everything just pull back to center. And just the observer watching the breath move in and out, in and out. Noticing how it feels, noticing the sound that it makes as it moves in through the nose, down through the throat, into the chest, into the belly, into the ribs. Sound that it makes as it leaves the body. And everything pulls back to center. Moving from center, moving to center. And then try to pull the breath now into the back body. So whatever you're laying on the floor, the blocks, the pillow, feel the press down into them. Mind staying with each round of breath. So from the very beginning of your inhale, how it changes where it is in your body, it changes how it feels, it changes how it sounds. The very beginning of the exhale. All the way out till the end of the exhale. And once that breath is gone, pause. And then the next inhale starts. All the way to the end of the exhale. And as we are here observing the breath and observing the body, how the body hopefully is softening, relaxing. You can also observe any thoughts that come into your mind. Without holding on to them, without following the story of the thought, just noticing the thoughts that come in and allowing them to go. Let's just be here for a few more rounds. before we really get going, putting out there anything that you need to recognize, any intention you need to set, any dedication, any feeling that you want to create for yourself. More big breaths, as big as you can get them. Inhale. Exhale it all out. One more, inhale. Exhale. And then stretch. Oh, wake up. Come off of whatever is underneath you or stay on it for a moment. Bring the soles of the feet in towards you. Let your knees rock left to right. Keep the feet pretty wide as you do that. And then keeping the soles of the feet down to the ground. If your arms aren't already, reach them back behind you. Feel like you're pressing into the floor and forward a bit. And then reaching out and away through your fingers so legs are active. And circle your wrists around. And just a couple times floating the arms. So stretch the arms up to the sky. And then down towards your hips, towards the floor. Inhale the arms up. All the way back. Inhale up. All the way down, maybe palms face up. Inhale up. As they go back, bend your elbows on that exhale. Just hold backwards. So elbows are bent. Open up the chest a little bit more. Now as your feet press into the ground, feel like your elbows are trying to reach out to opposite directions to open up the chest a little bit more. Breathe in. And out. And then stretch the arms one more time. Roll over to whatever side works. Move whatever is underneath you away. And then come on back to your back. And this time you'll hug your knees into your chest. Gently rock side to side. Circle your ankles out. And then just pause in the center. Turn your chin over towards the left shoulder. Let your right shoulder feel really heavy. Breathe as if you could breathe right into that space of tightness, top of the shoulder, at least for me. And then take it over to the other side, chin towards the right shoulder, left shoulder heavy, find some space. Maybe you need your hands like I am to give it a little bit of a rub. Then as you come back to center, grab hold of your kneecap. So we're going to take circles here at the hip. So draw your navel in so your back isn't moving around a lot, you're stable there. Take your hands, take your arms, and just straighten out the arms, pushing the knees away from you. And then you're going to go in opposite, so right arm to the right, left arm to the left, so go out to the sides, bring the knees back to center. Just do like four or five of those, taking it all the way around, breathing as you go. If you like them to get a little bit bigger, you can always stretch your legs out and around as you move. And then when you make it to number five, switch the direction out and around. Breathing as you go. Just the observer. Watching the breath, watching the thoughts. Pulling it back to the breath, pulling it back to the body, to the present moment. Hug the knees into your chest. Give it a gentle rock. And then I bring your feet back down to the ground. Nice and wide, arms out like a T. Drop both knees over to the right. Turn your gaze over to the left. So especially the left knee, it's reaching out and away, and maybe the left arm comes more of a diagonal by your ear. Stretch through that side body, breathe into your left rib cage. And then come back to the center, take it over to the left with the legs, stretch through the right knee, maybe the right arm reaches up, and you're breathing into your right rib cage. Come back to center. Once again, bring the knees into your chest, but this time let's bring the hands behind the thighs. Open the knees really wide. Get your sacrum down on the ground and start to walk your hands up. If they can go up, if they can't. Happy baby. Flexing the feet, gently rocking at the low back. So whatever hold you have of your right leg, keep it. Take the left pinky edge of left foot down to the ground, so it's like this half body konasana. Your left hand can be on your left inner thigh, giving it a gentle press. Your right hand can hang out and rock side to side. If the right leg wants to, is it ready to stretch out at all? Make it more of a diagonal, so not right above your face, but off to that right shoulder. And then hug your right shin. So grab the right shin, bring it to the center line, straighten out your left leg, reach it out on the ground. So now you're pressing through the left heel, and it's reaching out towards the end of your mat. Your right knee's pulling in towards your nose. Take an inhale on your exhale, curl your shoulders off the mat, knee towards your nose, give it a stretch. And then just let it go. Hug both knees in, gentle rock. Take it again, happy baby. Sacrum down, so there is a little bit of space between the low back and the floor. And then hold on to whatever part of the left leg you've got. Right pinky edge comes down. You can use your right hand to help open up that inner thigh a little bit. Left hand stays put. You don't have to do this part. If you're feeling ready, straighten out your left leg off to the side. Breathe. And then bend the knee, bring that knee back to center. Straighten out your right leg so the sole of the foot is pressing out through the back or the end of your mat. Grab onto the shin, take an inhale. As you exhale, curl yourself up. Feel like you're pulling your knee and your nose together, pressing through that right heel, give it all a stretch. Hug your navel in, both knees come in. Both legs up to the sky now, so curl out your ankles. All right, options here. We're going to heat up a little bit. So your right leg's going to stay up, and the knee can be bent a little bit, no worries. Left leg. So now you're going to pull your navel in. Feel like your low back is pulling a little bit more towards the ground. Left leg can come down a little bit, a lot. It can come to a hover, even sole of the foot to the ground. That's all up to what you're comfortable with, what your back is telling you you're comfortable with. Squeeze the inner thigh. So if this left leg was on the ground and you squeeze your inner thighs together, it would float off the mat. So that kind of power and strength there. Take an inhale. As you exhale, lift your shoulders. Reach your hands towards the end of your mat. Stay in your seat. Does this feel okay to you? If it doesn't, what does? Adjust for your body. Take the left hand on the outside of that right thigh. Try to get both shoulders, your right shoulder up too. Take an inhale. Exhale, curl up a little bit higher. Pulse. 10. Use the exhale to go higher. Belly drop, shoulders lift. 8. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Maybe both feet up to the sky. Can you touch your toes? Go past your toes. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Navel pulls in, shoulders lift. Navel pulls in, shoulders lift. 4, 3, 2, 1. Hug the knees in. Rock it out. If your head and shoulders need to stay on the ground, that's an option too. Other side, ready? Left leg will stay, right leg will go to where it can. And it is helpful to start. If you're gonna have that hovering leg, start with the right leg on the ground. And then if you squeeze the inner thighs and pull your low back towards the floor some, you'll feel that energy through the middle of the body here, that lift. Take an inhale. Exhale, curl the shoulders up. Find your pose here. Pull the low belly in and feel that. So the foot can be on the ground. Right hand on the outside of the leg, take an inhale. Exhale, pull the belly in, curl both shoulders up, and now pulse it out. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Both feet up. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Come again. Whew. so it feels good on your spine. You can even go back, back, back. And forth. Or it can be very slow movement. You don't have to do it at all. And then we're going to just cross the ankles and go all the way over to hands and knees. Spread your fingers wide. Gentle cat, round your back. Cow from here, let your belly drop, lift up your heart. Back and forth a few times. Exhale is the rounding. Inhale is the forward. One more time. If your toes are not touched, tuck your toes. Round your back, pull your body towards your heels, stretch your hands forward, stretch your feet up, stretch your back out. Breathe. Come back to hands and knees, and then into down dog. Spread your fingers wide, press into the knuckles, lift your hips. Start to move your dog as we do, bending the legs, straightening the legs, letting your body move around. Finding stillness in your dog. Knees can be bent a little bit. Pull your hips up and back. Shake out your head. Draw the front ribs in. Navel in nice and strong. Right leg reaches to the sky. And see if you can kind of find that feel of what we just did on the ground. Like squeezing the inner thighs, pulling the low belly in, the front ribs in. And then feeling like you're pressing your heel up. So there's some feel in the back of the leg. You can feel the hamstring and glute. Knee touches your left elbow across your body. Square off your shoulder. So if you're going to the left, you pull yourself to the right a little bit more. Keep that right heel pulling up into your body. Inhale, take the leg to the sky. This time bend your knee and open up your hip. Exhale, step the foot between your hands. Soften your back, knee down to the ground. Squeeze the inner thighs. Inhale, arms to the sky. So left hand, let's, from the shoulder, spin it so the hand comes behind shoulder blades, behind head, wherever you can get it. And you think about lifting up, up, up through your sternum, and then back some. Breathe. Breathe into the left side of the body. If you want to lean to the right a little bit. Maybe even the right hand reaching down towards the ground. We'll unravel this into a twist, so let your left hand come to the inside of your left foot, or right foot, sorry. And then that right arm reaches to the back of the room. So reach the right arm to the back of your mat, and then start to spin it up to a twist. Spinning your ribcage up. Take the right hand now, maybe it goes behind your head, and use your head to press back, open up through that armpit. If you're dumping weight into your left shoulder, lift out of it. Feel like your torso is leaning back a little bit. Find some space and breathe into your right ribs. And then as we let the right arm go, let's take it for a couple circles, just out and around. Opposite direction. Placing it down on the ground. Slide your left knee back a little bit. Stretch out your right leg as much as you can. Grab your blocks if you have them. You want them. Just a couple of big breaths. And as you're here, imagine your right sitting bone moving to the right, your left sitting bone moving to the left. So you're opening up space in the sacrum. Tailbone pulls back, heart pulls forward, stretch out a little bit more. Exhale, maybe go a little bit deeper. Bend into the right knee, lifting your left knee. If you want your blocks to help you here, or your fingertips, push into the blocks, squeeze the inner thighs, again, that idea that we had on the mat at the beginning, pull your belly in, see if you can lift your heel off the mat, and maybe the whole sole of the foot off the mat. Hold it, breathe. Step back, blocks come to the side, down dog. Take a breath in, take a breath out. Inhale, bend your knees a little bit. Look at your belly button. And then as your heels press back, straighten your legs, roll towards plank. Eventually the gaze goes forward. Yeah. Exhale, child's pose. Pull your hips back, let your head go. Hips pull to the right, walk your hands to the left, stretch through the right side body. Breathe. Come back to this one and take it over to the other side. Hips to the left, hands to the right. Breathe. Come back to center. Hands and knees, inhale. Cow, let your belly drop, lift up your heart, let your head move a little bit. Exhale, pull the navel in, come back to down dog. Feet might come a little bit closer, helps with your balance, left leg to the sky. But then again, try to find that pull in through the low belly, in through the ribs, energy, like you can really feel the press of the heel to the sky of that left leg, which activates the glute, the hamstring. Cross over to the right elbow, exhale, hold, check in and see that your shoulders are square, pull the heel up towards your body. Take it back to the sky, bend the knee, open up your hip, breathe into the front of that left hip. Knee to your nose, step the foot between the hands, soften your right knee down, squeeze the inner thighs, come on up. Now it's the right arm, find your armpit swirling in, bicep, bring the right hand back. So if it's not in between the shoulder blades, neck, head, and then think, sternum is lifting, 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 and then pressing back somehow. Breathe into the front of your right hip bone, all the right side body. Hug your low belly in at the same time. Maybe lean to the left a little bit. The right hip keeps pulling forward though. The right shoulder, however, can press back. Left hand reaches towards the ground. Create ease within yourself. With your breath. Unravel this. Move your right knee back a little bit. Left hand to the back of the mat. And then as it comes up, you're going to lean back a little bit. Hand behind your head, press your head back. You're still squeezing your left inner thigh, so that left leg hasn't really opened up too much if possible. Lots of space through your left side body. And then let the left arm go around, big circle. Opposite direction. Coming down to the ground, walk to the box of the right knee, move back a little bit, stretch out your left leg. Give it some breath, some time. Left sitting bone to the left, right sitting bone to the right, lift up your heart, tailbone back, heart forward, fold into it. Two more rounds. Back into the knee. All right, so if you don't have blocks, see if you can either do your fist or your fingertips. So the right hip pulls forward, the left hip pulls back. It's almost like if you were to take a cat here, so the energy in through the middle of the body here. You can see if you can lift your heel off the ground, maybe the whole sole of the foot off the ground. And then use that to step back, down dog. Take your breath in, let the breath go. Bend the knees, lift your belly button, use your legs, roll you forward, plank on the inhale, exhale, child's pose, pull your hips back. All right, this time look forward, your hands will slide forward, your butt will lift off your heels, it's a moment in a puppy dog pose. Breathe across your chest, and then press into the forearms to bring you all the way down to your belly. Wiggle out your hips a little bit. Bend your knee, lift your legs, rock a little bit. Hands slide a little bit lower than the ribcage. Press through the feet, hug the navel and shoulders back, baby cobra, inhale. Exhale, roll down, let's do three. Shoulders back, inhale. Exhale, one more, inhale. Exhale. Press up all fours, down dog. Take a breath in. Exhale, let the breath go. Right leg rises, straight back. Cross over to left elbow, exhale. Back up, bend the knee, inhale. Exhale, step the foot between the hands. Back knee down, arms up, inhale. Arc over to the right, exhale. Find your twist, left hand down, right arm to the sky. Lift the left knee, inhale. Exhale, two straight legs, pause. Bend into the knee. Inhale, gaze up, heart up. Exhale, straighten out both legs. Let your head go. Into the knee, gaze up, heart up. Exhale, straighten it out. Last one, bend into the knee. Inhale, all the power of this left leg brings your right leg to meet forward fold, top of your mat. Let your head go. Half lift, inhale. Fold, exhale. Knees can bend, inhale to the sky, rise. Catch your right wrist up and over to the left. Center, catch your left wrist up and over to the right. Back to center, lift your heart, open up your chest, bend your elbows. Interlace the fingers if it's working for you this morning. Push the fist away from you. And then with your feet wider, let your fist kind of rock left to right, right to left. Get some space in your chest. Big breath. And then slow it down, find center. Bend the knees a little bit. Feel like you're pressing down to lift up your heart to the sky. Lean back, open chest, open heart. Ready for your day. Exhale, bend the knees back down. Turn your head left to right. Just breathe. Hands come down to the ground. Right foot stays, left foot steps back. Right arm to the sky, twist, breathe, inhale. Exhale, step it back, down dog. So it's faster, but when you move, can you still try to find that lift to step back to down dog? Inhale, press forward, plank. Stay for the exhale. Inhale. Stay for the exhale. Inhale. Exhale, belly and chest to the ground. Same time. Shoulders roll back from your feet. Baby cobra. Inhale. Exhale, lower. Full cobra or up dog. We're staying with baby cobra. Inhale, press down. Lift up. Exhale, down dog. Hips to the sky. One breath in. And out. Left leg rises, inhale. Knee to right elbow, exhale. Back to the sky, bend the knee, open hip. Exhale, step the foot between the hands. Back knee down, hands up, breathe in. To the left, take a little bit of a side stretch. This cuts down to your twist, lift your right knee, left arm to the sky. Exhale, two straight legs. Grab your blocks if you need them, or your books, or whatever you got. Weights. Bend into the knee. Inhale, lift your heart. Exhale, two straight legs. Bend into the knee, lift the heart. Exhale, two straight legs. Bend into the knee. Inhale, now the power of your left leg, the pull of your low belly, steps the foot forward. Let your head go. Half lift, inhale, squeeze your glutes, draw on your navel and heels, pressing to the sides of the mat. Exhale, fold, head heavy. To the sky, we go, rise up on the inhale. Bend your elbows, this time right into it. Exhale. Hands behind the back, switch up the fingers, lift your heart, inhale. Take it down, exhale, let your head go. Hands down, right foot steps back, left hand to twist. Breathe in, open heart. Exhale, use your belly, send it back down dog. Inhale, roll yourself forward plank. Stay for the exhale. Okay, completely modify this. And you're gonna go knee to elbow. Or you're in plank, ready? Inhale, exhale, knee to elbow. Inhale, plank, exhale. Inhale, exhale. This goes a little bit faster. So you're forcing a bit faster breath. Really focused on the exhale, pushing it out. Go with an extra effort. Can your knee touch your elbow? Three, two, one. Hold plank, breathe in, push the ground away, don't let your shoulders collapse. Exhale, belly chest to the ground. Oh, goodness. Shoulders back. Inhale, baby cobra. Locus on this one, guys. Extend the arms back. So now that breath is whew, and the heart rates up, but can you, the powers of your breath, slow down? up, shoulders back, heart lifts. Exhale, down dog. Breath. I know it's there. One more big inhale. Big exhale. Right leg rises. Exhale, left elbow. This time, okay, the attempt is to straighten the leg out without touching the ground. Hold it, that's where the shoulders come. Bring it back in, all the way from the back, bend the knee, open up your hip. Exhale, step the foot forward. Same thing, guys. Back knee down, inhale, arms up. Exhale, over to the right. Inhale, brings you to your twist. I forgot what we're doing. Exhale, two straight legs. Woo. Bend into the knee. Inhale to the top of the mat for a fold. Exhale. Half lift, breathe it in. Hold a little bit deeper. Inhale to the sky, rise up. Bend your elbows, open your chest. Interlace the fingers, open heart, breathe in. Exhale, bend the knees, dive down. Stay here, breath in. Lift your sitting bones high, let your head get heavy. Now from here, feel the heels press out. Right heel to the right, left heel to the left. Start to bend into your knees. Keep your hands interlaced if that's possible. Pull your front ribs in so your fist is reaching back and your heart is reaching forward, giving you a little bit of stretch through the head, neck, shoulders, and extend your arms forward. Squeeze your butt, pull your belly in, chair pose. Exhale down, pull the belly in, inhale, open heart. Exhale down, belly in, lift your heart. One more down, a little bit lower, pull your hips back, pull the belly in, lift your heart. Hold. Exhale. Left foot steps back immediately into that twist, right arm to the sky. Okay. So, squeeze your right hip back, left hip forward. Pull your low belly and find the twist. And now, can you, reaching through the right fingers, can you start to float your left hand? Back leg is so strong. And now, can you, and if you had to, you could always bend that back knee, drop it down totally. Feel like you're lifting up, 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 up. Still in a twist. Right hand comes down. Left hand up to the sky. So we lift up, and at the same time, bend deeper into the front knee. And at the same time, reach back through the right fingers. Breathe into it all. Hands to center on the inhale. Warrior two, as you exhale. Come in and out of the right leg a couple times. Right leg. Only have one. And then hold it. Heels squeeze together. Extend the arms, palms, foot up, and just stay. Observe. Create your own calm, create your own peace. Reverse. Side angle, first go back. That right side body, nice and long. As you bring it down, right arm down, left arm to the sky. You could sink your hips a bit, but then lift your torso out of it. You could extend the left arm over the ear. My right arm's pressing into my right leg to help find a little bit more of that back bend, that twist. Straighten your right leg up and back, up and back, up and back. Breathe. Exhale, hands come down to the ground. Step back on the inhale to your plank directly. Exhale, maybe chaturanga, maybe you hit the mat. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. One breath in. One breath out. Connected to the breath. Not searching for it. It's there. Left leg to the sky. Inhale. Pull the belly in. And if you have been jumping these last several classes or your whole life, know that you can always jump too, right? Cross over to the right elbow. Okay. Maybe we can straighten the leg out without touching the ground. Whew, that's hard. Bend it back in, open by the knee, breathe. Step it forward on the exhale. Back knee down, arms up, inhale. to the left as you exhale. To your twist, right hand down, twist to the left. Two straight legs, gaze forward. Exhale to the top of the mat, all the breath out. Half lift, inhale. Full exhale, rise up, inhale. Up and back, bend your elbows, catch the hands. Dive down. Stay, breath in, breath out. One more. Let it go. Sink your hips down, down, down. Maybe they're like as low as your knees. I can't really see. Am I cheating? And then squeeze at your belly. So feel like you're trying to pull your belly up, which will lift you out of your legs. And then if you pinch your shoulder blades, your fist will reach back a little bit more. Stretch through the neck. Pull your belly in. Now can your butt stay this low and squeeze? So if you were to think of tap through your low back, so that slight rounding, pull your belly in, keep your torso parallel to the ground, and then extend. Maybe it's like 90 degree arms or forward. Your shoulders are not crushing your earlobes here. Your neck is long. You're breathing. Thumbs are reaching up towards the sky, so your back muscles are involved. Your belly is involved. All sorts of muscles. Exhale, let it go. Heart lifts. Left foot stays. Right foot steps back. Twist. Okay, here you go again. So your right hip's pulling back. Your left hip's pulling forward. Take a little bit of cat here to pull the low belly to float that right arm. Toes are loose. And then can you lift up, 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 up? And now as we start to take this twist, this is enough. You could totally stay right here. Otherwise, the right arm lifts up, the sternum lifts up, the knee continues to bend, and then you go back. Up and back. Up and back. Up. And back. Hands to touch. Inhale, center. Warrior two. Exhale. Slow down. Observe where you are in space and time. Reverse. Breathe out. Breathe back. Side angle, hips pull back, space through the side body, pull the front ribs in as you stretch. And then maybe the arm comes over the ear, left arm's pressing in, so it's feeling it twisting you a little bit more, opening into a bit of a back bend, breathing. Straighten front leg, whew, goodness. Up and back, up and back, up and back. Exhale, hands come down. Inhale, right plank. Exhale, belly and chest. We need an extra. Shoulders back, up dog. Exhale, down dog. One breath in, one breath out. One breath in, one breath out. All right, you ready? Right leg to the sky, straight back. So again, if you want to, keep it hop. Touch your left elbow, exhale, pause. Straighten the leg, maybe it doesn't touch. Maybe it stays not touching, I'm gonna let it drop. Back heel down, lift up, fall in triangle, breathe. Push through your left foot, reach through your left fingers, breathe. Hand comes down, hug the leg into your body, all the way up and back, now you can flip your dog. If you want to. And remember, you can always just drop your left shin down and take it more of this way. Maybe back then. Use your core to hug your navel in to step that right foot forward. Inhale, twist, right arm to the sky. Inhale. Exhale, take it up, take it up, take it up, take it up, and back. Inhale, find center. Straighten your right leg. Pull up and back. Breathe in, open your chest. Exhale, bend the knee, warrior two. Reverse, left hand behind you. Maybe you can push into the thigh, up and back. Find a little bit more space. Exhale, keep the left hand behind you. side angle. So if the left arm is behind you, you're trying to pinch your shoulder blades together to open up the shoulder, to open up the chest. Three breaths. If you have the full body, sure, take it. Swing your heart to the sky. One more. Straighten the right leg, pull up, let it all go, stretch. And when we're in a triangle, you can bring your back foot in a little bit closer. Hips pull back. Stretching, reaching. Right hand to shin, left hand to sky. Breathe. So your tail is going towards the end of your mat, your heart towards the front of your mat. Lifting out of it. Here I like to do the same thing. So palm, left hand to back, pinch your shoulder blades to move the arm. And it can wrap around, find that right hip. And it gives you a little bit of support, helps you to get a little bit longer. Start to carefully bend into the right knee. Whew. Let your right hand, left hand come to the ground. Fold into it for a moment. And then gaze forward, half moon. Block or no block. Use the power of your right leg to lift, lift, lift you up. Power of your left leg, that pinky edge. And then possibly bend both of the knees so you can catch your left foot. Kick it back, open up your chest, breathe. As we release this, well, I'm falling, but maybe you're a little bit more graceful. Left ankle behind the right. Just fold. Hips can pull to the left, hands can walk to the right, stretch. Come back to center, uncross the legs, half lift on the inhale. Fold as you exhale. Chair, sink through the hips, pull the belly in, lift up your heart. And now this time, lift up your heels. Keep your heels lifted and see if we can bring the hands down. Should have told you to keep your feet a little bit wider. So heels are already lifted. And then as your hands come down, maybe your knees can squeeze your armpits. And then start to push forward, forward, forward. Find your crow. Maybe the arms begin to straighten. Breathe. Step or jump back. Chaturanga. Skip it if you want. Up dog, meeting in your down dog. One breath in. One breath out. Two more, just like that. Big breath in. Big breath out. Last one, inhale. Exhale. Left leg to the sky, inhale. Right elbow, exhale. Straighten the leg, maybe it drops, maybe it doesn't. Back heel down, lift up. Fall in triangle. So press through the right foot and reach to the right fingers. Lift up your hips high, breathe. Hand comes down, hug your navel and squeeze the inner thighs all the way up and back. Possibly flip your dog. Modify if you like. Press down, lift up, same thing. Breathe. Hand comes down, navel in, step the foot between the hands. Inhale, find your twist. Open heart. Exhale, squeeze the inner thighs. Use the power of the exhale, the core, to lift you up and back. Inhale, hands knee. Straighten your left leg, lift up. Breathe in, open up your chest. Warrior two. Right arm, so it goes back and around. Right arm behind you, pushing into the thighs. You lift up and over, reverse. Exhale, use that hand to pull your hips back, pull your belly in, spin your heart to the sky. Side angle. Low belly pulls in. Now you could remove it like you did last time, or see if you want to keep it there. Straighten the leg, up and back, up and back, up and back. Maybe bring your foot a little bit closer. Continue to pull the hand back as you come into triangle. Hug the navel in, twist through the ribs. Breathe. Careful, I'm lying the arm. And just bend your left knee a little bit as you pause before you yawn. Bend into the knee a lot, move forward. So that left, right leg's already lifting you. And you're lifting out of your left hip. And then you can also bend both of the knees. You can catch the foot, kick back, open up your heart. Bending both knees, carefully, slowly. Cross right ankle behind your left. Bend your full length. Hips pull to the right, hands walk to the left. Come back to center, uncross, lift heart, inhale. Just fold, exhale. Inhale, chair, go low, hand up high. Sink back a little bit. Pull the belly in. Prayer twist to the right, left elbow outside of the right thigh or on the inside of the left inner thigh. Hips low, hips back. You can open your arms if you want. Pull the belly in, twist the ribs. Pull the belly in, twist the ribs. Center on the inhale, squeeze your glutes, lift your heart. All the way up to the sky. Take your feet a little bit wider. Open up, up, up. Look here, a big X. Arms are wide, feet are wide. Open your heart to the sky. Exhale, all the way down to the ground. Feet remain wide, half lift, inhale. You can grab your big toes, you can grab your ankles, pull yourself into your folds. Exhale. Do it again, inhale. Exhale, open the sitting bones, let your head go. One more time, inhale. Exhale. Heel toe, the feet a little bit closer together. Half lift and fold. Chair right into it. Let's pull back, arms up. Well, left, you go. Hips pull back, belly holds in. Exhale, twist. So everything else remains square, right? If you look at your knees, one is down in front of the other. Your feet are parallel. Your butt is as low as you feel like you can go. And then your twist, your every other twist is for the ribs. And you're using your abs to make that happen. Maybe the arms are open. Two more breaths. Can you pull your hips back and down? Breathe. Hips back and down. Breathe. Come to center, squeeze your butt, lift your heart. Exhale, let it go. Whew. Half lift, inhale. Just pull it, exhale. Half lift, inhale. Just pull it, exhale. If you want it, one more crow. I'll meet you in down dog. Plank on your inhale. Belly and chest to the mat. Exhale. Okay, let's just be here for a second. Wiggle out your hips a little bit. Bend the knees, rock them out. And then you can stay with locusts. Or we'll take our both legs. Let's do locusts together first though. Find the toenails, hug the navel in, bring your hands a little bit lower than the ribs. Roll the shoulders back, pull the belly in, lift up your heart. And then extend the arms. And if you're feeling it, you can squeeze the hamstring glute and lift up the legs as well. Inner thigh keeps spinning to the sky. And let it go. Close your eyes, breathe. Your heartbeat. Observe your breath. Forehead down. Totally done one at a time, right? Okay, so you could just do your right foot, you could just do your left foot. You don't even have to lift off the ground. Make this as modified as you want it to be. Hug your navel in, arms are ready to go. Squeeze your heels towards your butt, catch your feet. Bring the hands to where it's good. And then hug your navel in, pinch your shoulder blades together and see if the shoulder blades, your core, can float your chest, just like you would have done in your locus pose. Maybe that's enough. Hug your navel in, begin to kick your feet back. Eyes lift. And then let it go. Switch to the opposite cheek. Just breathe. Bend your knees, start to let the legs, again, windshield wiper side to side. And then carefully pull yourself up to all fours. Kick your knees wider and then just make circles. Circle the hips all the way around. Go in the opposite direction, all the way around. Very gentle path. Just stay. Let your hips move up to the right and to the left. Very gentle cow. Child's pose. And then from here, let's just sit up. Put your hips over to one side, send your feet forward. Cross your right leg over your left. Press through the ball of the big toe. You can keep your left leg straight or bring it in. Just are you able to be on both sitting bones? Lift tall. And then twist to the right. Open up to the opposite side. And as you come to the center, unravel so the right foot is on the left inner thigh. Open it up a little bit bigger. Again, find the sitting bones, left hand to the right thigh. Get as tall as you can get. And you're twisted towards that right side. And then think up first, up, 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 and over. Up, up, up. And over. And I'm using my left hand to push into the thigh to help get a little bit more. A little more space, a little bit more twist. Breathe. Lean back some. Maybe you can catch into that whole hammock move. And pull yourself carefully up, and then find the inside of this left leg. So you can pull that left hip back a little bit and stretch through the right fingers. Breathe. Go to find the hip. Both feet come forward, kick out a little bit. Left leg crosses over. So if we get cut off, just do the other side. We'll be on a couple of minutes. Get tall. Twist over. Bring your left foot in. Breathe. Pull back a little bit. Observe this moment. This breath. Open up to the opposite side. And as you unravel it, right leg goes out, left leg on the inner thigh, and you can open up the shape a little bit more.
Right arm to the outside, thigh both sitting bones. Push down into the thigh, lift up out of it, up and over, up and over, up and over. Maybe the hand comes behind you. Sorry for all of the dinging, it's not my phone, but it's my kid's iPad. Breathe. Careful to pull yourself out. Side is tight. And on the inside of that right leg, stretch through, especially it's the left hand and your left sitting bone that are grounded super. Stretch that left side body. Breathe in. Carefully pull yourself out of it. I will turn it off. Bring both legs straight forward. Take a hold here. So just forward fold. Bend the knees, let your head go. Bend your back. Okay, so per the usual, if you have time to play around with anything you've been working on, do that. If you need a little bit more back bending or restorative, definitely Shavasana. I am so grateful to be able to hang out with you. I definitely enjoy my time hanging out, playing around. But yeah, Tuesdays. I'm going to try to do Tuesdays. Around 7, and what else? Hang tight, you got this. Namaste. I'm gonna come on down to my mat. If you're still with me, go ahead and bring the knees in, jumping rock out your lower back. Take one last happy baby. Last twist. Awesome. And once again, you become the observer of the breath, the thoughts, the heartbeat, the body, the moment.